plumber. It's hard to trace the origin of an obsession. Did he become a plumber because he was so obsessed with pipes? Or did his interest well up after spending so much time with these fittings in the plumber's merchants? Any conversation he had would be steered onto his favorite topic. A discussion would be manipulated and contorted, twisted and welded, as if he was fitting in leaden pipes. No matter how remote the connection, any subject would be related to pipe fittings. Oh yes, of course he developed theories. Meteorology was understood in the following way. Clouds were formed by pipes which took water from the ocean up to the sky. No evaporation, just the simple pumping of vapors up invisible tubes to the sky. Invisible to the naked eye, but somehow perceivable by him. Of course, you know about his paintings. I quite liked the series Plumbing the Ocean. There were also still lifes and even portraits, bad copies of the Altmeisters, with the heads and limbs replaced by pipes. Ridiculous. Or his friends would pose for him in an old shack by the sea. Again and again, the vanity of the patron swept aside in favour of a tube of copper. You should see his handwriting. It evolved over the years into a pipe calligraphy. It was quite mysterious. And I don't know if it was an actual language he made up for pipes to burble to each other, or whether they spoke to him in a secret tongue, or what. Who knows what went on in that man's head?